for starters, how did you get the clue? Did you know Dr. Bellick? Were you with him when he found the progenitor's technology?
You ask a lot of questions.
Others are coming and they're way less friendly.
If they got their hands on what you're hiding, it would be a disaster.
These answers you want, if I give them to you, they might cost you your life. You sure it's worth it?
We've already risked our lives to come this far. We're sure.
800 years ago, Federation president brought together six scientists in secret. Me, Dr. Bellick, and four others, Federation and non-Federation. Don't ask me their names, I won't tell you. I will tell you that our mission was to research the progenitors and their message.
The one Captain Picard found.
Yes. It took years. It eventually led us to a sector of deep space where we found a technology beyond anything we'd ever seen. One of our group tried to activate it. He was killed. After that, the rest of us made a pact. Told the president that we'd hit a dead end, destroyed all of our research, removed our names from every database we could access. And we hid the location of what we found.
Why didn't you give it to the Federation for safekeeping?
The Dominion War was raging. Everyone saw an enemy in everyone else. And we knew that technology could be used for great destruction. Protecting it became the focus of our lives. Nothing was more important.
You know where the technology is. Why not just tell us so we can secure it? We can actually skip this whole clue trail.
No. We created the clues so that no one could reach the end unless they followed the full path. We wanted the power to be found, but only by a worthy seeker. And only when the time was right, a time of peace, when species have evolved enough to use it only for good. So tell me, in 3191, has that time come?
This is a time of peace.
You don't look so sure.
Oh, I am, but I can't promise you it'll last.
Okay, there. That's where the clue is hidden. There's a carving. Just below it is a crack that opens into a compartment I built into the rock.
That's it? Yeah.
What?
They can cloak.
Their scales control the way light refracts.
That's another thing you could have mentioned, y'all.
Take cover!
Well, the hits just keep on coming.
Everyone's agitated. They don't back down. We have to go now.
No, we can't. We need the clue.
Well, you're not getting it tonight.
What? There has to be a way.
There's no way. We stay, we die. With this body, your friend dies. I'm not gonna let that happen.
See if you can communicate with it.
I can't. Connection's a two-way process. It's blocking me.
Could you pick up anything?
Yeah. It's really pissed off.
We didn't need any of their powers to tell us that.
Time for plan B, then?
On the count of three.
Hey!
Go, then. Xenoanthropology. Show respect to the one you're studying. Try to communicate with them again. Now, tell them we're sorry and that we are leaving.
They're letting us go.
Find another way to get that clue.
I see you survived.
Skin of our teeth.
You knew that was their nesting ground, didn't you? And you had us draw our phasers to incite them. Why?
I had to know what you'd do when you encountered a life form vastly different than your own. Would you just see an enemy? Or would you try to connect? That's vital for whoever gets the progenitor's technology. As is the belief in the potential for goodness in all beings. Proceed wisely, Captain.